Restart, presume. Substitute, my name is Davion. Welcome back to the channel. So today we're going to continue with Alan Wake. I'm recording this right after, I'm recording all of these Alan Wake videos really back to back. Last episode we basically escaped. We woke up at Hartman's clinic, found out that he claims that Alice is dead. He claimed that Alice is dead. Alan doesn't believe it, and we're trying to just get out of here. We had to get out of here. We found Barry. Hartman's dead, and a few other people are, I guess, gone. But yeah, now we just got this, and we just had to get this maze. So now we're just gonna continue where we left off. Let's just do it. There's no better time in the game than today. Oh, come on. Already. The episode just started. Oh, finally.
You're now leaving Bright Falls. Come back soon, sign.
We're going to the Anderson farm.
I knew you were going to say something like that. You know what? You owe me big time for this. When this is through, if we make it, I don't care what anybody says, I'm done with darkness. You're going to buy me a tanning bed as a gift, and I'm going to live in it.
Don't worry. We'll both be done with the darkness.
Crazy, but that's fine, Barry.
Oh, you got that right, Al. You're barking mad. You are by far the craziest.
But maybe that's inevitable when you deal with crazy stuff like this. It helps. This is happening, Barry. Alice, they never had Alice. She's trapped in the darkness at the bottom of the lake, but she's not dead.
Al, how can you know that?
I know, Barry. I can.
Al, I
know. Listen, I can bring her back. I can find her.
How?
There's something special about this place. The lake, it does something to the works of art created here. It makes them come true. But there's a catch. The dark presence, whatever that thing is, twists it to its own ends. That's why all of this is happening. It's using my manuscript to take over everything.
Al, I believe you.
It happened to Thomas Zane before, it happened to the Andersons.
I believe you. Crazy or not, you're not delusional. We're going down. That's a fact. I'm on board, man. I'm with you.
The Andersons knew about it, but they were too far gone to tell me with all the drugs they were on. But they wrote it down. There's a message somewhere at their farm, Barry. We just need to find it.
Look out!
Uh-oh. Oof. Well, that happened. And we're still falling. Oh, Barry's okay. Alan's okay.
I had lost my gun in the crash. Barry was nowhere to be seen.
Barry! Barry!
Oh, man, you're okay! Jeez, it's good to hear your voice! I was trying to get out of the car, but the ground gave way. What a drop! Don't worry, your cutout is fine.
Forget that. Are you okay?
Hit some bushes, didn't get a scratch. There's no way you can climb down, though. It's like a sheer wall. Al, there's something moving down here.
Barry, it's a take it. Use the flare, Barry.
Yeah.
Barry, are you all right?
I'm good, Al. I'm great. Guess you never messed with anyone from New York City before, huh?
Barry, this.
I'll be waiting.
Let's say, Barry,
just wait. wait for me, okay?
Ow! I'm not staying here! It's suicide! I'm going to the farm! I'm gonna go ahead and secure the area! You can catch up! Don't worry about it! I'm on the case!
Now he's Rambo. This would turn into a disaster if I didn't catch up with Barry.
Well, let's catch up to him then.
A car was driving away from the farm, headed in the same general direction as I was. For all I knew, it was Barry, caught in the consequences of leaping before looking. Was heading for the cabin up ahead. It wasn't far. If it was Barry, I would see the damage soon. I could see the car, but there was no sight of the driver.
Hello? Anybody here? Barry!
You were in jail the other day.
I went to the farm again. For the moonshine, you know? It makes you see. You're not gonna miss it. They're in the loony bin. My buddy, Danny. I lost him. Something's gone wrong with him. It's not him.
Well. Guess he's gone.
I'd known the brothers used to be some kind of rock stars, but it hadn't really sunk in until I saw the stage.
I didn't expect to see a stage myself. Okay. This is most likely. This is getting. Ow. I hope not. Whew.
That was awesome!
Bright Falls, rock and roll capital of America.
Let's keep going. Okay.
See, bestseller, no reason to worry. Your cutout's good as new,
goodness.
Right where I left it. I'll come back for it once we have the place secure.
Yeah, that's been my biggest worry all this time. We need to get this thing moved out of the way.
This is as far as I got before they ambush me.
Well, good thing I'm here, because I always got ideas and plans.
Wow! You look at that thing, Al! They really went all out with this Viking crap, didn't they? Look at all this stuff! They must have done okay for themselves, so how come I...
Episodes.
to work together to open this gate, Al. It's pretty heavy.
Man.
The power downstairs was out, but I was sure I could fix that at the fuse box.
Hang on, so... The Red Vikings... Or, just have to do with Asgard. Yeah, this is a copyright most This is a good idea.
Lots of hours before dawn. Might as well get some rest. And by rest, I mean drunk.
Come on, Barry, this is...
I don't know if... If I was in this situation, I don't know if I'd be able to sleep.
I could write 10 books a year, and they'd be the best books that year.
No, you couldn't.
That's right, I couldn't. But I could, because I'm a writer.
What? What do they put in this stuff? I feel like my brain is coming out of my nose. I'm gonna get the recipe off those coots and be a booze millionaire.
I just miss her, Barry. I just want her here with me.
I know. But it's gonna be okay. We're gonna make it okay.
Idiots. And he fell asleep on the floor. Again, I'm not sure if I'll be able to sleep through all this.
Drunken dream, and yet it was more than that. It was the truth, a suppressed memory unearthed by the Andersons' moonshine. I was there, an out-of-body observer. This was the night Alice and I had arrived at Bright Falls, the night Alice had disappeared. I had a chance to find out what had happened. I remembered being surprised to see the cabin dark. Alice would have never turned the lights off. I remembered thinking, I caught a glimpse of her form underwater, sinking into the darkness. Diving after her was the last vague memory I had of that night. After that, the next thing I could remember was waking up behind the wheel of the crash car and finding the first pages of the manuscript. Beyond this lost memory, there was nothing. I had to follow the footsteps of my past self to find out what had happened that night. I couldn't find her in all that blackness. I must have thought she drowned.
Alice.
Jagger had Alice, and so she had me. I'd been easy prey.
Look at the cabin. Is there someone in the window?
Alice?
Maybe she didn't drown after all. Maybe she's inside.
Alice!
Yes.
Presence had touched me. She had dug her nails into my brain and used me, made me her puppet.
She must be here somewhere. Maybe upstairs in the study.
Alice!
Yes, that's where she is. You can apologize.
Alice!
You'll laugh at the whole thing together and put it in.
Alice!
She's not here. You were foolish to think so. No, she's dead. She drowned.
No, no, no!
It's your fault your wife is dead. You are guilty. All she wanted was to help you write. You killed her. Oh, hush. You're still home. Cauldron Lake is a special place. Here, you have the power to change things. She wanted you to write. I will tell you what to do. You can write her back. The story will come true, and all will be well again.
She had Alice, and the manuscript was the ransom for her.
Yes. All right. I'll fix it. I'll bring her back. No. I wrote it.
I remembered it all now. In the dark, I'd written for days, a week, almost a complete manuscript of a novel entitled Departure. Jagger had been my editor, whispering in my ear, making sure that the unfolding story would make her more and more powerful. I thought I was saving Alice.
So that TV we heard,
some part of me had been aware of
this
escape into the story, to bring a light into the cabin to release me before I could finish. To interrupt the horror story before the ending, where darkness consumed everything and everyone. Zane was weak and far away, but I had written him into the story, and his light had been enough to set me free.
It isn't here now. I'm here because it was written. I brought the light to set you free. You must hurry. We'll know I'm here. It will be back soon. She stole the skin of my armor a long time ago. She looks so old.
I had woken up, confused and groggy, my mind consumed by darkness and fear. All I could do was to escape. The week spent in the cabin had taken its toll. I was barely conscious and fading fast. It had to have cost Zane terribly, thrown him even deeper into whatever dark place he now haunted. But he had managed to weaken the dark presence, kept me safe that night.
Yeah. That's when you have the wreck.
I wrote it. It's my fault.
That's right, James Joyce. It's your fault, and you're gonna pay for it.
Well, that's the end of episode 4. Episode 5, The Clicker. Well, that'll be it for this video. Thank you all for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe. I'll see you in my next video. Peace.